Hello and welcome to Mike's Garage. If you're enjoying our videos, by all means, please subscribe. And when you do, be sure that you tap on the little notification bell so you'll be notified every time we get a new video up. Okay, let's get right into it. You know, I've gotten a whole lot of comments from people, and make no mistake, I really enjoy the comments. And so far, I've been able to sit every day and answer the comments. I've lost a couple clicking around and doing things. If I didn't answer your comment, believe me, it was totally unintentional. I've gotten some really fun comments from people all over the world, and it's wonderful. I really appreciate them. Okay, moving right along. Was I supposed to not say that one? Anyway, what I have here is this wheel that I've pretty well finished. In our last video, you know, we trued this thing and it really came out nice. And I talked about torquing the spokes. Now, on a lot of these videos, I'll do them and then I think back after I'm done and I say, gee, I wish I had showed this or I wish I had shown that. So, what I have here is two different torque wrenches for torquing spokes. This one is your typical mechanics inch-pound torque wrench, and I took this, I think it's called a torque adapter, and it was a tool from Snap-on, and it's what I use, and you've seen it in the other videos, when I torque down shovel or pan head cylinder heads. Well, I had one that I had ground on, and anyway, I made a notch in it, and it's on exactly a 1-inch center here. Exactly 1 inch from the drive. But it really doesn't matter because when I tighten with it, as long as I do it at right angles, then the torque reading that I have set is correct. It's not changed. Okay, I have another torque wrench here. Now, this one actually came from Buchanan's. This is a spoke torque wrench. And I love both of these tools. On this particular one, I used my clicking torque wrench. I assume that torque wrench there is still available. I don't know. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to torque this one set of spokes. Now, I've already torqued it, I'll be honest. I've already torqued it. It's already all set. The wheel is true. Everything is fine. But I wanted to demonstrate actually torquing it. Now, right now, I'm torquing it at 50 inch-pounds, which is correct for what I'm doing. This is a front wheel. These are standard polished stainless steel spokes, and it's not like it were a rear wheel with 140-pound foot-pounds of torque going to it at the drags, which would be another thing. So all I'm going to do is tighten these, and what I do is, if you want to be sure that you're starting and stopping and getting them all, you always start at the hole for the valve stem, and that's pretty easy. So there we go, there's 50, 50, look at that, 50, get that in there. Now, like I said, this one's already torqued, and I'll probably come back and check it again when I'm done. Now, if in fact you have to tighten a spoke again to get the same torque, it's just relaxed and now you've been able to do it. So you can match it up with the other side by checking it to see that it's true again when you're all done. And if you have to tighten and loosen in order to do that, that's the way we do it. Okay, the next thing I wanted to talk about is when you get this all torqued and done, which this one is, quite often you're going to have, in fact, usually, you're going to have the ends of some of these spokes protruding through the nipples. And those will poke holes in the tube. You can't count on a rim band to protect you on that. What you got to do is grind those smooth. And when you get done grinding them, then use a new rim band, new tube, a new tire, and you'll be in heaven. So what I did is I got out my little grinder here. And I'm going to grind one off just to show you that I'm really going to do it. Let's see. Let's find one that's easy to see. And there it is. Now the cool thing about that is by using that little grinder, I didn't mess up my rim. Using a big die grinder with a big wheel on it, and you'll have a mess. Anyway, so that does it for now. All I wanted to do was show the actual torquing of the spokes and what it takes to grind the ends of the spokes so that they're smooth right up against the nipples. So that's it for now. I think we may come back on another video and show setting the end play on the bearings, packing those bearings, and installing the seals. So we'll probably be doing that one real soon. So until then, I'll see you out on the road.